1976, my father acquired what would eventually become the Hourglass Estate. I had grown up here in Napa Valley and seen all of these amazing changes and the evolution, really, of the modern wine business as we knew it. My father was managing the vineyard and contracting the fruit to a variety of various wineries. I was off chasing a music career, fronting an indie rock band, doing the whole San Francisco club scene and having the time of my life. And then my dad got really sick and passed away very quickly. My mom was kind of faced with, I've got this property and I don't know really what to do with it. I sat my mom down and I said, Mom, you can't sell this property. You just can't. I think there's an opportunity here. I was able to convince my mom to repurpose the vineyard, replant the vineyard to Cabernet, and join that whole new movement of modern winemaking in Napa Valley.
He was getting ready to replant, and I started bouncing some ideas off of him. I was going to UC Davis, and that's when I started doing research for Mark Cleaver. I thought, okay, it'd be great to bring one of my professors, especially Mark, who's a pretty famous viticulturist.
True to form, Kelly delivers, and he gets Dr. Cleaver to come down and give us a site evaluation. When he was done, he turned to me and said, Jeff, I think your dad acquired what will become one of the marquee Cabernet sites of Napa Valley. And he said, Jeff, you've lived here all your life, but you probably never considered the Napa Valley's more or less shaped like an hourglass. Your hillside vineyard defines the pinch with a narrow crossing. That's a completely unique geography to Napa Valley, and you're really at the epicenter of this hourglass. I was like struck instantly by the name. How often does the place actually speak the name in that way?
Very good parent material, you know, mainly volcanics on an upheaval, which is A quality for Napa Valley.
All the great estates of the world start at great properties and they build out from there.
Our site had a personality, a unique energy to the wine, and we didn't want to play with that. But how do we then grow? We decided, let's get another wine that qualitatively could be an equal, but stylistically would have its own expression,
and acquired Blue Line Estate in 2006. You really feel the energy both at Hourglass and Estate and here, the Blue Line Estate. Our identity is very obvious from when you walk in here to when you leave. Friendly people, great wines, great sights.
It's really all about creating a family atmosphere that makes everybody fall in love with each other and the product, and it's just been magical to watch.
That's our goal, is to try to capture the energy of Hourglass Estate in that bottle, then to capture Blue Line in that bottle.
We are making modern Bordeaux varietal Napa Valley wines, and they are estate driven. The estate element is there for a reason. We are true believers that a place has a magic to it, and it's our job as winemakers to steward that vineyard into revealing that personality and delivering that back out.